SpaceX is getting closer to launching a Starship to space. The company continues to prepare the Starship SN24 and Super Heavy Booster 7 prototypes for the debut flight, which is planned to originate from Boca Chica Beach. The ambitious orbital flight would allow engineers to test the concept of operations for the Starship launch system and collect technical data about the rocket ship to speed up its development. Join us as we bring you, SpaceX tested record number of Raptor engine at once for the first time. SpaceX has performed multiple pre-flight tests of both stainless steel vehicles in the past year to ensure it can withstand the pressures of the upcoming spaceflight. A SpaceX Starship booster has successfully fired up 14 of its 33 Raptor engines, likely becoming the most powerful active rocket in the world. Throughout the history of spaceflight, only 3 or 4 other rockets have produced as much or more thrust than Super Heavy Booster 7 could have theoretically produced on November 14. But the Soviet Energia and N1 rockets, and the US Saturn V, and Space Shuttle were all retired one or several decades ago. Only SpaceX's own Falcon Heavy rocket, fifth on the bracket and capable of producing up to 2,325 tons of thrust, at sea level, is still operational and comes close. Powered by 33 upgraded Raptor 2 engines, that SpaceX says can produce up to 230 tons, approximately 510,000 pounds each. Super Heavy could have produced up to 3,220 tons of thrust when it ignited 14 of its engines earlier today. That likely means that Starship is now the fourth most powerful rocket ever tested, slotting in above NASA's Space Shuttle but below the Soviet Energia. And even if all 14 engines never throttled above 73%, SpaceX's Starship booster likely still produced more thrust than any other active rocket in the world, beating Falcon Heavy. But if NASA has its way, Starship could hold the title for less than 36 hours. On November 16, a little over 35 hours after SpaceX's record-breaking Starship static fire, NASA will attempt to launch its massive Space Launch System rocket for the third time since late August. At the explicit request of Congress, which wanted to preserve shuttle jobs after the end of the program in 2011, SLS essentially shuffles around Space Shuttle parts and replaces the reusable orbiter with a fully expendable rocket. The solid rocket boosters have been extended and uprated, and the orange external tank has been stretched and turned into a liquid rocket booster, affixed with 4 RS-25 engines to the shuttle's 3. If things go according to plan, those changes mean that SLS rocket will produce up to 3,990 tons, 8.8 million pounds of thrust, when it lifts off for the first time. Overtaking Super Heavy Booster 7, but also making it the second most powerful launch vehicle in history, after the Soviet N1. N1 never succeeded, however, so SLS could become the most powerful rocket ever to reach orbit, if its first launch is successful. But just as SLS appears poised to almost immediately unseat Starship's position as the most powerful active rocket in the world, Starship is poised to beat SLS to become the most powerful rocket ever flown, successfully or not, when it attempts its first orbital launch, either next month or early next year. With all 33 Raptors at full throttle, Starship can produce almost 7,600 tons, 16.7 million pounds of thrust at liftoff, beating the previous record holder, the Soviet N1 rocket, by nearly 60%. SpaceX has never ignited all engines simultaneously. We can expect that to happen soon, before the gigantic rocket propels Starship SN24 to orbit. Booster 7's 14-engine test comes after SpaceX founder Elon Musk appointed SpaceX president and chief operating officer Gwynne Shotwell as lead to oversee Starship development at Starbase this week. With 33 Raptor V2 engines powering it and plenty of evidence that those Raptors are far from perfect reliability, the concern is understandable, even if the response is a bit different than SpaceX's norm. Prior to the start of preparations for Starship's orbital launch debut, SpaceX sped through Starship development, like it wanted to destroy as many rockets as possible, which, to some extent, it did. Rather than spend 6 to 12 months fiddling with the same few prototypes without a single launch attempt, SpaceX churned out Starships and test articles and aggressively tested them. A few times, SpaceX pushed a little too hard and made avoidable mistakes, but most of the failures produced large amounts of data that was then used to improve future vehicles. The holy grail of that project was high-altitude Starship flight testing, which saw SpaceX finish, test, and launch a new Starship 5 times in 6 months, and culminated in the first fully successful high-altitude Starship launch and landing in May 2021. There's no specific date set for the fully stacked Starship Super Heavy debut orbital flight. If testing continues to go smoothly, the flight could potentially happen in December before 2022 comes to an end. Starship SN24 is expected to be restacked atop Booster 7 in the coming weeks. Next big test is probably full-stack wet dress rehearsal, then 33 engine firing in a few weeks, said Musk in October. Meanwhile, engineers continue to build a fleet of shiny stainless steel Starships at the Starbase factory. Each will undergo the same testing, until SpaceX achieves developing the final iteration of the launch system, that will return NASA astronauts to the moon and take the first humans to Mars. Even if that first launch attempt is unsuccessful, SpaceX appears to be preparing for several more rapid-fire launches, that will continue until success is achieved, beating SLS, other, potential, record. SpaceX has demonstrated that ability once before with Starship, when it completed 5 flights of 5 different prototypes, in less than 6 months. As a result, it's likely that by the time SLS launches a second time in the mid-2020s, it will be the third most powerful rocket, second to N1 and Starship. That slightly awkward upset should be lessened by the fact that Starship and SLS are, for the time being, both integral parts of NASA's Artemis program. To return astronauts to the moon for the first time since 1972, SLS and its Orion spacecraft will transport NASA astronauts to lunar orbit, where they'll board a Starship-derived moon lander. Starship will then land those astronauts on the lunar surface, support about a week of surface operations, and then return them to lunar orbit, where Orion will transport them back to Earth. For now, a massive amount of work remains to be done, before NASA and SpaceX will be ready to support that crewed moon landing. But Monday's Starship static fire, and Wednesday's potential SLS launch both represent significant, tangible steps towards that lofty goal. That SpaceX will have 2 pairs of orbital-class Starships, and Super Heavy boosters, B-7 and S-24, B-8 and S-25. Ready for orbital flight by then, potentially enabling a rapid return to flight after the first attempt. Musk is also excited about Super Heavy Booster 9, which has many design changes, and a thrust section that will fully isolate all 33 Raptors from each other, crucial for preventing the failure of one engine from damaging others. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.